UFC Fight Night 157. It takes place in China, and this will be an amazing event considering that Shenzhen Universiade Sports Center will feature a few really really good combats. Okay, there are no high known names unless the main event of the evening here, but we will guide you through. And I've picked three bouts. For one, you will say, man, why are you choosing that damn preliminary card? Because those two guys are very entertaining by something. Let's go in the combat between Su Mudaerji and Andres Sukamtat. Now, Su Mudaerji, the Tibetan Eagle, yeah, I think I wrote well, Tibetan Eagle. He is a Chinese guy who had pretty much solid career at WLFWARS organization, and he was scoring so many good wins. He has even one flying knee win, many TKOs. When it comes to submissions, well, it's not his stronger side, definitely. He is not good in a submission game because all three losses came via submission. He had only one UFC bout, it's against Luis Smolka, where he suffered a submission loss via armbar. On the other side, we got Andres Sukamtat, the Asian sensation. I guess you all know this guy because he is the first Lao-born mixed martial artist ever to compete here, and he is the former CES MMA bantamweight champ who won that vacant title, and he has some really really good matches behind. But he was losing to Albert Morales, Alejandro Perez, Sean O'Malley, Montel Jackson. He has only wins over Luke Sanders and Jonathan Martinez. So this is be or not to be for Andres Sukamtat. And if you ask me, Andres Sukamtat mustn't lose or he's down. He'll be down forever if he loses. So, on the other side, the Chinese guy is a very very dangerous one. I've got to tell you, this guy is super dangerous. I predict a good bout, but a victory for Andres Sukamtat. Now we're going to the co-main event of the evening. Li Jingliang versus Eliseo Zaleski dos Santos. Li Jingliang, well, you will say I'm insane because Wei Zheng fights for the title, but Li Jingliang is the greatest Chinese mixed martial artist of all time. The Leech, brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I've got to say, he's a long-time UFC competitor and the former legend FC welterweight champion. Let's see, I mean, he was losing to Nordin Taleb, Keita Nakamura, Jake Matthews, but he has strong kicks, he has strong punches, he has good submission game. I mean, submission loss to Keita Nakamura, if you follow UFC, then you know it's not a shame. Keita Nakamura is a tough, tough rival. On the other side, Eliseo Zaleski dos Santos, well, this guy is a mystery. He hasn't fought for a very long time. I mean, his nickname Capoeira, it should tell you something on him. Mao Tai, BJJ, Capoeira. He's kinda, I don't know how you say it. I'd call him an all-arounder, you know, and he's the former Jungle Fight welterweight champ. Paulo Costa also defended that title, and he is so good. This guy is running on an amazing 7-fight streak. He won last 7 combats with last loss to Nicolas Dalby, which came via controversial split decision in his home country of Brazil. Well, spinning wheel kick, punches, this guy has what it takes. Now, I've got to say, I'd pick here. Maybe this is an insane decision, but Li Jingliang is awesome in front of the home crowd. He defends submissions well, but Zaleski dos Santos has some very very entertaining strikes. I think Li Jingliang has maybe 51% to win this bout, but this is a very very controversial. And now Jessica Andrade versus Wei Li Zheng. Oh, that's the bout you're all waiting for, right? Jessica Andrade, you all know her. You know what she did to Rose Namajunas and how it ended. On the other side, Jessica Andrade has amazing wrestling skills. Very, very strong girl. Bate Staka, her nickname, and that kind of victory over Rose Namajunas kind of shocked me, because in the first place she lost to Joanna Jędrzejczak via unanimous decision, then she decision Claudia Gadelha, Tesha Torres, KO'd Karolina Kowalkiewicz and slammed her way through Rose Namajunas' 4-win streak, undefeated since 2017. Tough opponent, strong punches, but especially strong in slams. Very, very strong girl. On the other side, Weili Zhang, well, she's not the most powerful puncher you'll see, but she's the first Chinese mixed martial artist who fights for the title. Sanda, Shui Jiao and BJJ competitor, she has some unorthodox skills when she strikes and so on. But don't forget, she has decision win over Danielle Taylor, submission win over Jessica Aguilar, and decision win over Tesha Torres, and she is a former KLF strawweight champion and vacant top FC strawweight champion. Kunlun, she also had great results here, Chinese Kung Fu Championships. I mean, this girl has a heart, you know. She is not so strong, but she is a kind of a girl. She worked as a fitness instructor, you know, and transited to MMA. So she has power, but she is not as powerful as Jessica Andrade. Can she surprise her? Well, she can. She actually can. There will be no size advantage and so on, but you know, this girl from Beijing, China, she had great moments, so if the fight goes to the ground, I believe she'd have chances, but Andrade can slam her, as well as you saw against Rose Namajunas, but in the stand-up I don't think Weili Zhang can knock her out, so I'd pick Jessica Andrade here.